and this is funny, they said to me, you can never be active because you have an enlarged heart. Mm. So you can never, you know, do very much because you have an enlarged heart. But I believed that God could give me a new heart.
Amen.
Because he has spare parts in heaven.
Amen.
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 And so we were in a meeting, and really, Pastor Lawrence wasn't very spiritual. But I believed God. I believed his word that in that meeting, I would get a new heart.
Amen.
So on the way home from the meeting, I said to my husband, I have a new heart. And so I went and had it checked, and do you know, they said to me, you have the most wonderful heart. And almost every 2 years I go for a checkup, and they always say to me, you have the most wonderful heart. We'll have a new one.
Amen.
I have a new one. God has spare parts for
Amen.
You.
Amen.
So stand up. Put your hands up. Say, God,
God
has a miracle.
That's a miracle.
With my name on it.
With my name on
Amen.
It.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. You can receive it. I get very excited when I look at all of the ways Jesus has to heal us. So I want to refer to Luke 5:17, where it says the Spirit of the Lord, the anointing, was present. The power of the Lord was present. And it's a very unique miracle. And I have found that miracles begin with an act in the natural. There's something we do in faith that starts it. Then God shows up and gives us a miracle. And then we live in the lifestyle of that miracle.
Amen.
So let me give you an example. Moses, you know, he came to the bitter water, had all of these people there, you know, the water was bitter. And so he said, God, what shall I do? And God gave him an act in the natural. He said, cut down a piece of wood and throw it in the water. So he did that. Everyone say, act in the natural.
In the natural.
Then God revealed himself with a special revelation, Jehovah Rapha. Say, Jehovah Rapha.
Jehovah Rapha.
Now, I love this name of God because it's more than the Lord your healer. It's the Lord your help. So why do we have to go downhill because we get older? But he is our help. Amen?
Amen.
And then we live in the lifestyle. And what was it? Moses lived to 120. His natural force was not abated, and his eye was not dim. So, what's this act in the natural? We do something we believe. Amen?
Amen.
Then we receive a miracle. Everybody say a miracle.
Miracle.
But then we live in the lifestyle of that miracle.
Amen.
So stand up again. Say, I believe.
When I act in the natural,
I receive a miracle.
I receive a miracle.
But it's a lifestyle miracle.
It's a lifestyle miracle.
Not just from occasion,
but
lifestyle.
Amen.
So this morning when you receive your healing, remember, you are living in the lifestyle of that.
Amen.
And Jehovah Rapha means the Lord our health. So put your hand on your heart. Say, I won't forget. Jehovah Rapha means the Lord our health.
Amen.
It keeps you healthy all the days of your life.
Amen.
You can receive it. So I want to look at 8 ways God has to heal you. So when we look here at Luke 5:17, there are 4 faith friends, and I call them crazy faith, because they had a crippled friend, and they wanted him to be healed. Now, when they brought him to Jesus, if you remember, it was so crowded, so full, they couldn't get him in to the presence of Jesus, but they didn't give up. You never give up until you win.
Amen.
The game is not over until you win.
Amen.
Thanks be unto God who always leads us to triumph in Christ.
Yes.
And through us diffuses the fragrance of his knowledge in every place.
Amen.
Amen.
Put both your hands up and say, the game.
The game.
A little louder.
The game.
The game.
It's not over.
It's not over.
Until I win.
Until I win.
Amen.
Amen.
So what did they do? They dragged that lame man up, dug a hole in the roof, led him down into the presence of Jesus. Now watch this. That would have been expensive, you know, to do that. I mean, who wants to drag a lame man up? And probably the lame man had faith too, because what if they drop him? He's worse than he was before. And so they drag him up, cutting a hole in the roof. That's expensive. And they led him into the presence of Jesus. And it says this, Jesus saw their faith.
Amen.
Faith pleases him.
Amen.
So I want you to stand up. If they have told you, you have an incurable condition, you can't be made whole, would you stand up? This is your morning, June the 4th.
Amen.
A miracle with your name on it. All right. Now, everyone seated, I want you to be my team. And if you do a good job, you can travel with me. So everyone seated, extend your head, say Jesus.
Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I send a miracle.
I send a miracle.
Into this body.
Into this body.
I speak wholeness.
I speak wholeness.
From the top of their head.
From the top of their
head. To the tip of their toes.
To the tip of their toes.
I'm a crazy faith friend.
I'm a crazy
I have faith for them.
I have faith for them.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 So we see, you can be seated, that you, the prayer of faith can be a united prayer. People having faith for you. I'm not sure the layman had faith, but the friends had faith.
Amen.
And that is very, very key. Now, another one, another way that God needs to heal the sick is the laying on of hands. And this is Mark 16, 18. They will take up serpents. If they drink anything deadly, it will by no means hurt them. They will lay hands on the sick, and they will recover. The greatest miracle I ever saw was through the laying on of hands. It was many years ago. A man came to our city named A.A. Allen, and my husband and I were in the ministry. And we helped in that meeting to lead people to Christ. They had big altar calls. People came to Jesus. And we would go in the back to pray with them. So we were in the back praying for people. And there was a man there lying on a cot, pitiful, pitiful looking, all withered, and, you know. And I said to the people with him, what's wrong with him? They said, well, he has tuberculosis. And both lungs have been eaten away by tuberculosis. And we're waiting for Brother Allen to come back and lay hands on him. So Brother Allen came back, and you know, it wasn't real sensational. He just came back and he said, prop him up. So they lifted him up. And he said very, how can I say, very easily, quietly, in Jesus' name, receive new lungs. And he touched each side of him. Now, I don't remember names well, but I remember this man's name. His name is Gene Mullowitz. So years later, 6 or 7 years later, I'm going to Little Rock, Arkansas to speak in the church. And the pastor came to the airport, he and his wife, to take me to the hotel. And I said, now, what is your name? He said, my name is Gene Mullowitz. I thought, Gene Mullowitz. That name is familiar to me, but I couldn't, you know, identify it right away. And so then I'm thinking, and I thought, Gene Mullowitz, that's the name of the man 8 years ago that I saw A.A. Allen lay hands on. Well, he doesn't look like that man. So I told him about this. He said, I'm Gene Mullowitz. I have new lungs.
Wow.
He's the laying on of hands. Now stand up, I'm going to pray over your hands. Because believers are to lay hands on the sick and they will recover. Did you know there's healing and miracles in your hands.
Amen.
It's not how you feel, it's what he says.
Amen.
So I want to pray over your hands.
Amen.
I mean, Singaporeans have wild faith.
Amen.
Wild faith. You believe they can do anything.
Amen.
You have the word and the power of the Holy Spirit. So pray with me. Say, Father.
Father.
I recognize that I have healing,
and
miracles in my hands. I can lay hands on the sick,
and
they will recover. In the next 7 days,
leave me
to someone
who
needs a healing miracle,
and
use my hands
in Jesus' name.
Amen.